Thanks, little guy.
Ding-ding.
Oh, thank you.
Ding-ding.
Did I miss something? When did we get to Disneyland?
Ding-ding.
Tina, this is your friendly neighborhood chaos coordinator, bar manager, Wookiee Wrangler, Stephanie Janicek, bringing you Star Wars news today. So Matt McGloin, the editor of Cosmic Book News, was at San Diego Comic-Con and wrote an article about a spoiler he'd heard about The Rise of Skywalker, and basically said if it happens, it'll take away some of the pain from TLJ. He was also told everybody hated TLJ, and, you know, basically the stuff that we've all been told by people in Hollywood. If you talk to people there, they're very much vocal about their disgust with TLJ. So what's this spoiler? I don't know. But he didn't really go into it. He said if he talked about what the spoiler is, that it would give away who he got it from. Which is like, look, dude, if you're gonna do that, don't say anything. Just don't. That's a bullshit move. But he said it had something to do with Tatooine and Luke or Palpatine. I'm gonna put the article in a pin note so you guys can read it yourselves. It also had something to do with Rey. And what's really funny is that when you're watching the teaser that came out, I'm sorry, I know it's not supposed to be Tatooine, but when you see her running away from the TIE fighter, obviously it's Kylo Ren flying it, and you see Finn and Poe and 3PO in that what looked like a runaway sail barge to me, being chased either by, I'm going to say, I hate the First Order because it's so stupid, Imperial Biker Scouts, because that's what they look like. So original. Wow, JJ, you really went on a limb to really create a whole new world. It's one of the things I hate about him, is he's about as creative as a, you know, JJ Abrams is about as creative as a dirty wet sweat sock. Okay. So, you know, it looks like Tatooine to me. Those desert sequences don't look like Jakku. They look like Tatooine. Okay? Now, apparently it's not supposed to be. Then you get this teaser, this spoiler, hint, hint, from Matt McGloin. Who knows? All right? So what do I think? Well, here's what I think. And I'm going to say this, I'm going to be very honest. It kills Reylo. The teaser killed Reylo. Daisy killed Reylo. It's been killed over and over again in interviews. Daisy poking fun at Reylo's on TV kills Reylo, which is good. This also kills Rey Nobody, Rey Luke's clone hand, Rey Palpatine, Rey Kenobi, Rey. So she's a Skywalker of some sort. Now, go back to the teaser trailer. We got Luke's. You can't take everything he's saying as one whole sentence because it's a teaser trailer. His overview could be filled with the whole paragraph before he says the end of it. Okay, we're going to only concentrate on what he says at the end of it. Again, actions right now speak louder than words. What he's saying, his presence is felt. Leia's obviously got Han's metal from Yavin, okay? And she hugs Rey, and she's wearing the ring, mommy's ring. You know, then we have, we will always be with you. Luke's not talking, necessarily might not be talking about the Jedi before Rey. He's probably talking about her family. Okay? That guy right there? Him. All right? I find it very interesting that now we've got this spoiler. Of course, we're not told what it is. Just say it. I don't... Just... Why would you tell somebody then say I can't? Then swear in secrecy? You know? Here's what I think is going to happen. I think eventually, sooner rather than later, Rey's identity is just going to get leaked. It almost has to be. Part of the reason is this. The Reylos are out of control. People need a reason to go see this movie, okay? And there ain't one. There just ain't one. You know, Matt McGloin can say, well, this goes a long way to help fix what they broke. Does it? All right, I'm going to give you a little bit of insight. Star Wars Disney canon, Disney sequel trilogy has sucked since The Force Awakens. Okay, now I know a lot of people that are subscribers that are going to watch this disagree with me. I'm telling the truth, okay? It took me a year to admit that movie was garbage. Why? It takes everything that Lucas built, all the character arcs, and throws them into a dumpster and lights them on fire, okay? It's literally, you know, you can't take a character like Han Solo and do a 180 character reversal. It doesn't work that way. That's not a natural progression for a character. There has to be a reason, and we haven't gotten one yet, all right? And that's partly J.J. Abrams' fault, okay? So we got that. Trash is Leia. Instead of making her like this Winston Churchill type figure, you know, back in the 30s, I'm going to give you a little bit of history lecture. Back in the 30s, during the wilderness years, Churchill sort of did what he did. Okay, he called out the Nazis. He was there sniping at the British government, Ramsay MacDonald and Neville Chamberlain. And when, after the Germans invaded France, he was finally brought in as prime minister and helped save the world. I could have seen Leia having a similar role in that. Okay, and part of it, people sniping at her because of Vader. Okay, let's Han's role in this. Han will be quietly helping her build up a secret army to take on. Does it necessarily have to be remnants of the Imperial, remnants of the Empire? Or maybe it's somebody else. Maybe it's something else. You know, why didn't the galaxy grow beyond this? Okay? Because in the EU it did, and it made sense. Now we've got a rehash of... I mean, didn't we already go to this dance? Didn't Anakin and Luke already get rid of the Sith together? Why are we doing this again? I mean, Sith troopers who look like they just got dipped in, Andy Gutierrez's red nail polish. You know? So we've got all that. We've got this thing that has to answer so many questions. And the problem with TFA is, how did Han lose the Falcon? Why did he lose the Falcon? All right. Why don't we see Luke on the island more? Conversing with Force ghosts, dealing with Sith ghosts, like maybe the Sith ghost of Darth Vader shows up, maybe Palpatine's ghost shows up, maybe Revan's, maybe Bane's, maybe Darth Malgus. You know, there should have been something going on there, all right? Luke is on a spiritual journey. His journey is not Han's. All right, I'm going to remind you guys again. Luke is a spiritual warrior. Han is the warrior lover, okay? They're, as far as I'm concerned, equals in this story. Regardless if it's Luke's or not, Han is every bit as important as Luke is. If it wasn't for him, Luke would be dead. The rebellion would have been destroyed. Leia would be dead. Okay? Give the guy some props. You know? And it really was, I mean, it really, when you look at TFA as a whole, it was a lazy, hastily written piece of shit. All right, I've said this before. You took this vast galaxy to even in A New Hope, when you see Luke looking up at the setting, binary suns, Tatoo 1 and Tatoo 2, going down on Tatooine, you get a sense of just how gigantic the galaxy is and how that almost like eternal struggle out there in that galaxy is about to reach down and touch him. Okay? Because he's got the heralds, R2-D2 and C-3PO. Okay? He's off to go, and he's going to go off to find his mentor. All right? And then he'll go off, then he'll run into his friend and comrade in arms. Okay? This is both Nordic sagic form, Western saga form. It's Arthurian, Greco-Roman mythology. Okay? With a heavy good dose of Eastern philosophy and Eastern mythos. Okay? There's a lot of spirituality surrounding all of the characters. You know, what their names mean. Han Solo. I mean, think about what the word Solo means. Leia Organa, natural, of a natural being of the earth, of, you know, of substance. Luke Skywalker, that is a heroic name. Okay. All right. You know, and you could even go into, all right, Vader, that word actually is Dutch for father, which is like, you know, should have been obvious right there then. It is now. You know, Anakin means of, you know, akin. Darth Sidious, Insidious. Names mean something. You got this vast mythology, this vast galaxy that is turned into this big by J.J. Abrams and Lawrence Kasdan, because they have neither the patience, they had none of the time, nor the ability and vision to add to that advanced, huge galaxy teeming with worlds we haven't seen before. We've seen Jakku. It's called Tatooine. Okay? I mean, all right? And how small is a galaxy when, you know, Starkiller Base can just shoot out flames and blow up a system? You know, when you can actually see the streaking, whatever that is, energy going above the sky of Takodana. What? It's this big. It's not huge. All right? Now, sure, I mean, could you see a supernova going off in broad daylight? Yeah, I mean, when Beetlejuice goes, we'll probably be able to see it for days. I mean, you know, but that thing's billions of light, you know, hundreds of millions of light years away, isn't it? I mean, tens of thousands of light years away, all right? So, you know, watching these things streak through the sky in real time, I mean, really? That's how small the galaxy is. It's like across the street from Jakku. I mean, so the problem started with TFA. Okay, the problem started. Trashing Han's character, giving him a 180 character reversal is bullshit. Not utilizing Leia's standing to its full effect. All right? Is bullshit. Turning into a gray, crazy, dried up hag is bullshit. You know, there's a reason for it. Lazy fucking writing. Okay? And, you know, then we got the mystery boxes. Okay? So we got JJ now trying to fix it. Ruin Johnson. Threw away. I'm looking at this as driving past a car accident very slowly, you know, rubbernecking as we go by. I have morbid curiosity, and because we have suffered so much as Star Wars fans at the hands of, at the shitty treatment we've gotten from Lucasfilm, at the obnoxiousness and disgusting behavior of Ray Lowe's, I'm just going, you know, if we get Rey Solo, that helps. But still, JJ, you are part and parcel to how that movie got fucked up. You, and on your head be it. Okay, my man? Okay, my guy? All right? So, do I have any hope? I remain cynical. I have the EU. I have the OT. I have the prequels. And as far as I'm concerned, until Disney apologizes, fixes what they broke, stops with this bullshit, not one dime. Not one dime. And I'll tell you something. Galaxy's Edge is empty for a specific reason. Because the sequel trilogy is empty. And Galaxy's Edge is nothing more than the physical manifestation of the emptiness, shallowness, hollowness of Disney canon Star Wars. This is Steph signing out. Here on the Galaxy, here on the Cantina. Please remember to tip the Wookiee bartenders 20%. No droids, no bounty hunters, no Rey Lowe's, no Rey Nobodies, no Rey Luke's clone hands, no Rey Kenobis, no Rey Palpatines, no Rey, none of that. Okay? No fights in the Cantina. No gunfights. You take this shit outside and out in the street. See you in the Galaxy, Scott. Oh, yeah. And for you fan fiction people out there, and for people who want to preserve Star Wars the way we knew it for future generations, I am working on a Han Solo origin story that I think pretty much kills Solo, a Soy War story. I think you guys will like it. This is not the Han Solo that Alden Ehrenreich played. This is the Han Solo Harrison Ford played. And I think you guys are going to like it. So it's almost finished. I got to do some tweaks to it. I got to send it out. And when it's ready, I'm going to post it. In an announcement here, and it'll be posted also in the description so people can read it and enjoy it. And hopefully if I get a good enough feedback, I'll adapt it to a screenplay, and maybe, you know, we'll do a charity fan film. You know, I know the money is I know the money is a question mark, but, you know, we can dream, can't we? Steph signing out. See you on the Galaxy Scout.